TESOL jobs in Argentina. General information. In a continent where baseball and U.S. television is enormously popular, there is considerable enthusiasm for learning English. However, it is American English that has most currency and is most sought after, not British English. The distinction is noted by locals, bringing considerable advantage to Canadian and American candidates. Nevertheless, there are many opportunities, and, as ever, persistence pays dividends. Those actively looking for work will find it and be rewarded by the experience of teaching some of the most enthusiastic, fun-loving students on the planet. In addition to this, America is seen as corporate big brother. Its influence and presence is pervasive. Teaching. Quite unlike Europe, for those wishing to teach in a state or private school, a TESOL qualification is more than enough. Teachers certainly don't need a PGCE or an undergraduate degree. Nor is there a requirement for 2 years as teaching experience. With language institutes, you can expect to find yourself teaching those who work in business or tourism, less so those doing it just for fun. This needs-driven market makes for sharp, well-motivated students. Don't expect to find people dozing at the back of the class. Commensurately, these people are paying for the privilege and will expect a respectable, well-turned-out, professional teacher. Another thing to be aware of is that, because Latin languages are inflected, students will naturally have a much higher awareness of grammar than native English speakers. Be on your mettle and prepare well. You don't want to have your knowledge of tenses tested by your students, who learned them all by heart before they were 10. Because of the huge variety of standards in education, you can expect a commensurately patchy student body. Some will have very little experience. However, others, privately educated, will have many years' experience in studying English. Latin American students are amongst those most highly and warmly spoken of by experienced TESOL teachers. Expect fun, great enthusiasm, but don't be surprised if nobody shows up, if there is a major sporting event in the offing. Visas and regulations. For those with need of a hobby, a full-time occupation, and/or a passion for the Kafkaesque, then by all means, make an essay of getting a work permit in Argentina. With this said, naturalization, e.g. the legal right to work and reside, which is strictly necessary in, say, the EU or the US and Canada, is not paid much attention to in Latin America. Most teachers in Argentina work on a tourist visa, crossing the border every 3 months to renew it. However, if you feel you must get naturalized, then you will need a 1-year contract from an employer, a certificate from the police in your country of origin stating that you have been well behaved in the previous 5 years, your birth certificate, all of which must be authenticated by the Argentine Foreign Ministry. For all practical purposes, you do not really need a work permit to work, and you will not get a work permit unless you have a job, and will not get that kind of job unless you have a work permit. Perhaps the wise job seeker, in the best of all possible Argentine worlds, directs their attention to their visa requirements and entitlements. This will depend on what your country of origin has fixed up with the host country. You can find all about this from your local embassy. Think about also what you have to do to renew your visa. All the way back home, or does a cross-border trip do nicely? How many times can you renew your tourist visa? Popular destinations. Buenos Aires, the capital, boasts cafe-lined grand avenues and cobbled back streets in a style redolent of Europe. An atmosphere of faded grandeur is propped up by the cockiness of the inhabitants, even in times of great political or economic adversity. It has a cosmopolitan atmosphere and is a great place for a huge steak prior to heading out to party all night. Córdoba is the education capital of the country, sporting 7 universities. As a college town with a high IQ, it is alive with interesting people, and there is plenty to do on a budget. Mendoza, on the other hand, with the streets lined with giant sycamores, puts you in the middle of the desert, as you will notice from the high temperatures, but a desert made green by the toil of plantation owners. Getting a job. A modicum of preparation prior to setting out will pay dividends. Think of not one country in South America, but the whole continent. You may end up moving around quite a bit once you hit this part of the world. Hence, it is a very good idea to contact all of the Latin American embassies in your country of origin, inquiring about teaching and visas, and see what you get back. You will find that you have a nice big file folder of leads and information that will vary from country of origin to country of origin, Latin American embassy to Latin American embassy. Like most Latin American countries, jobs are mostly gained on the spot. Hence, you will need a letter of introduction in Spanish, your resume or CV translated accordingly, plus a translation of your transcripts and certificates. But there are judgment calls to be made. You don't want to use any old Spanish. Venezuelan Spanish will appear idiosyncratic and strange in Argentina. The best bet, if you can, is to use Castilian Spanish as spoken in Spain. This is seen as the mother tongue, universally comprehended, and carries style, weight, and considerable currency throughout Latin America. Equally, hone or acquire those language skills. Latin America is not the Costa del Sol in Spain with its huge English-speaking tourist industry. Do not expect English to be widely spoken or used. For all practical purposes, a little bit of Spanish can go an awfully long way in determining both your employability and the quality of your experience. Again, one should be aware of the wide variety of different Spanish dialects in use across the continent and choose carefully what idiom you acquire. In Castilian, as spoken by the King of Spain, calzon means, after the Italian, a pizza folded in half. In Mexican Spanish, it means underpants. Hence, caveat emptor. Language acquisition takes time and effort, and the buyer should beware what Spanish they buy into. Again, to all intents and purposes, Castilian both sounds upmarket and is most widely understood. Nevertheless, expect fertile ground for amusing confusion here and there as you travel from country to country. There are avenues which can be utilized to gain a placement prior to setting out. Most U.S. TESOL schools have close ties with one or more Latin American countries. The Language and Training Group of the British Council arranges for language assistance to be placed for one academic year, though applicants must be 20 to 30 years of age with at least A-level Spanish. The Association of American Schools in South America acts as a recruitment agent. Candidates must pay $25 to register, then the placement fee is $300, normally reimbursed by employers. The South American Explorers keeps lists of schools which employ English language teachers and maintain a database of volunteers. They charge $50 a year for membership, with a $10 premium added to non-US members to cover the cost of postage. Amity volunteer teachers abroad are active in Latin America, offering 9-month placements. Look out for the Buenos Aires Herald, which carries job advertisements for English teachers, and the main notice board in El Latino, the English language bookshop at 340 Calle Florida. Another good contact is the Instituto de Lengua Española para Extranjeros, or ILE, where Spanish taught to foreigners, and there is a good notice board. For many, getting a job will mean knocking on doors, hence, the need for those translated documents. Helped, hopefully, by a smattering of polite Spanish. The local yellow pages, see below, detail universities, schools and language institutes, etc., which are often only too willing to interview candidates. Highly qualified, and more importantly, well turned out, organized and enthusiastic teachers are in short supply. If they like you, they will most certainly find some teaching for you. Hence, one of the best and most realistic propositions is to build a working life based around constructing a curriculum a few hours here and a few hours there, bearing in mind that revenue from privates can double a teacher's income. One should always be on the lookout for private students, whatever one's employment or visa status. The market for those wanting private tuition or conversation practice is huge and potentially very lucrative, therefore, not be neglected. Give yourself time to build a portfolio of work. This is best safeguard to both your income and employment status, the latter of which can be highly fluid with schools and language institutes. TESOL jobs in Argentina. If you want to obtain your TESOL certification in South America, our high-quality courses in Argentina might be the best choice for you. Upon successful completion of the course program, you will be the proud owner of one of the most valuable TEFL certifications in the world of English language teaching. During our TEFL training program in Argentina, you will learn how to effectively teach English to non-native speakers and receive IT professional recruitment. Many trainees like it so much that they simply stay in Argentina after completing the course to work as an English teacher. Due to the flourishing job market for English language instructors, our TEFL graduates have little trouble finding a suitable position across the country. While there are many jobs available in the capital of Buenos Aires, medium-sized and small cities also offer valuable TESOL positions. Argentina has long been a favored location for many TESOL trainees due to its lively cities, dynamic nightlife, low cost of living, welcoming people, and astonishing scenery. And don't worry about your personal schedule, as our course in Argentina is available year-round. TESOL Course Argentina. What place could be more suitable for your TESOL training program than the exciting capital of Buenos Aires? Once there, you will soon become a local and find your way through the many secrets of the South American lifestyle, while living in a city marked by elegant European influences like no other place on the continent. After class and on weekends, you are able to enjoy all that the city has to offer and even get to venture far outside the city borders to explore the fascinating natural wonders of Argentina. If you prefer to stay close to the center, you can dance the night away, indulge in the fabulous local cuisine, and enjoy some of the most exquisite wines on the planet. Should Argentina not turn out to be your place to be, many other countries in South America offer great employment opportunities for TESOL graduates. Just let us know where you want to go next, and we will be happy to assist you with your job search.